Morning, Veena.
Good morning, sir.
And I want you to explain a little bit background and the inspiration. And also, can you please let us know about your journey and inspired you in the work of social development sector? How did your early experience at Indian Express and Dr. Patra Positive Healthcare shape your career? These are the questions you can answer, and the rest of the questions our team will continue.
Sure, sir. To begin with, founding VK Sharanya was, in fact, after 13 years of my corporate experience, which had come down to social sector. In social sector activities, the reason why I got into this was my last stint, which I worked in at CMS Infosystem. And during that time, I was heading training. Therefore, I got to travel across Pan India. So it was then that I had seen rural parts of India. And then I actually noticed that people are willing to work, but at the same time, they are not being paid on par with what people earn in cities. So the gap which I found was education and training. Therefore, then I had set up a training institute through which I had conducted training and done placements in corporates and also in hospitals. And post which I had registered this organization and we started working doing NABARD projects, wherein we got to work with farmers. We've done financial literacy programs across Pan India, and during the time in 16-17, we had opened more than 59 lakh accounts for the farmers.
59 lakh accounts?
Yes, this was in 19 states. 19 states.
When you say financial literacy, what is that? Basically, you are into microfinance or savings, self-help groups.
How we had done was we had created awareness through street plays conducting in regional languages. And we had also made an audio visual in Hindi and regional languages. It was dubbed. We had shown this to gather people in villages. You need to connect with them with folk art. This is what we noticed.
Okay. So our intention is we have our own NBFC, we have our own CSR funds. So we want to work with them as a PPP model where we can demonstrate some models in every village so that they can replicate. That's our intention. So we don't need to reinvent the wheel. We can align that. If that is your experience, immediately after this interview, you can share your profile. We will make you as one of the lead trainer for the fintech finance module. So you will be wherever we go, we can go as a team. We don't need to have to. Because see, you have experience, you already done, you know the field, you already done with MCSR. What we can go back to the same field saying is, hey, we want to upgrade this. So is it okay? You don't need to invest anything, we will take care of. Only thing you need to give permission. That's all. In case if they are investing also, we can show them I have an NBFC. They can create the, we are ready to put the debt as long as they are going to give a leverage. We are getting now 1 to 5x to 10x also, we are getting leverage.
Okay.
So we can disperse. Let's say we put 1 crore. Let them disperse 1 crore, 10 crores.
10 crores.
That's where we can make good money. It's like a win-win. We don't need to go back and tell kind of. So anyway, that's the post-interview, you can do that. So we are open to, you can share the PPTs, everything by mail.
Yes.
We'll check it out and see your profile. And also, if you are willing, you can. But good. That's a huge.
Yes.
What is your team size?
Full time I've got 11, but when I had project, I had 125 employees across.
So I would like to go ahead with the next one and would like to hear from you. How do you ensure effective project management and timely completion of the programs within your budget constraints?
Okay, what we do is generally when there's a project, okay, and we have that given to us from the client, okay, accordingly structure the project and we plan our manpower according to the locations. We first conduct a train the trainers program. Even if our senior most employees are trained, okay, yet because it is a different location, going from this hometown to a different location, again gelling with those local people, it does take time.
Right.
So trying to understand the craft of that particular location, it would take us at least 2 or 3 days connecting with the local people, then making a team, and then we train them and we used to go ahead.
Great.
So therefore there was no problem in handling that or the completion of project timely.
Good to know. So train the trainers has helped you in order to operate in a better way.
Yeah, always. This is how I have always been doing. Probably that is because I was working as head of training in CMS and for past 7 years before moving to social sector. So that impact would have been my support in connecting this.
Great, that's great. So in this scenario, what strategies did you use to manage and motivate teams across diverse geographical locations?
As I said earlier, I do, because we have worked across Pan India, I do have people who can come just a call away for the project, because everybody across are looking for work, right? Because not all of them are full-time employees.
True.
And then I've been living in Mumbai for last 22 years, but then I'm in Hyderabad for last 6 months now. So I have got this team in Hyderabad and Mumbai. Okay. Now, what I would do is we would first understand the project, okay? And then connect the right person to the right place, and then plan accordingly. And then there as well, we stay there for at least 2 or 3 days, connect with the local people, understand the local craft, then conduct training for the local people as well, explain them the project, why we are doing the project, how we could benefit them, and then we would go.
Great, thank you. So it's basically connecting with the local community of
things. Yeah, that is the only way you can connect. You cannot do it individually as saying that this is my team and I'll do it. No, it doesn't happen that way. You have to involve the local people, then only we can complete it.
Do you have any success stories like where collaboration led to significant community benefits?
Yes, certainly. Yes, it did. See, with CMS Info System, after I resigned from the company, that was the program wherein we helped. They have sponsored one of our health programs. Okay, that time we were working with global hospitals in Hyderabad. So in fact, during the camp itself, there were 2 cases where people had actually got an attack, and we were so scared. Those people were saved. That was one of the success story, I would say. And after our cataract operations, that was one. And for the farmers thing, where we had conducted training programs, inviting the agricultural university professors and officers, and they had conducted training programs for the farmers. That was one.
So you have received several awards and recognition.
Yes.
In this sector, like including from Tata Memorial Hospital and NABHA.
Yes.
So how do these acknowledgements influence your work?
I think that is because of the work which all the team had done. So not just me, but all the team which has done. And because it was the complete team which had worked even to get those health camps organized or blood donation camps done for Tatas, I think that I would say.
So how did you approach designing and developing training modules and programs for different sectors, especially in medical industry?
Especially in medical industry?
Medical industry. How did you approach and like designing and developing training modules?
See, I had worked with Dr. Batras for some time. Okay, at that time I was a patient care executive myself. So as a patient care executive, you connect with the patient first, you understand why the patient has reached the clinic, right? Then you write because it's a homeopathy clinic. So in a homeopathy clinic, first you need to understand why the patient has come for what disease, from how many years. Then you connect with the doctor. So connect the doctor, and then the patient going to the doctor's cabin, there's a gap of half an hour. Okay, during that time also conversing with the patients, also you understand what they need at home as well.
Okay.
With that, I think as time goes by, as we grow, we understand the need, right? And then at home also, I lost my parents. Okay, and I've got my sister who isn't keeping well. Okay. Now taking care of her, and then my father-in-law, he passed away because of cancer. All these incidents have also, they make you so matured and understand, because you yourself are going through that phase.
Yes.
So you
can see
life experiences.
Which is like initiative is trying to address the best services for rural India, medical systems.
Medical systems, I think for rural India, if I would say, because all the rural people cannot travel to the cities, I think the best thing we could conduct training, I mean camps also for them, would be having a mobile clinic.
But anybody started that?
Yes. Just yesterday, I read about some companies who are sponsoring, and having worked in Mumbai with ICS, yes, Indian Cancer Society, they also have this.
See, I am also, as an organization, to empower Pragati, like how you worked in CMS.
Mm-hmm.
So I've trained more than around 900 to 1,000 members of BCs. But okay, they're not approved DC. They have done the NSDC skill training course.
Okay.
I'm talking about the people who are working in the field as a BC. Do you know them?
Yes.
You have good connection with them. So suppose if you top up some product with the BC for the existing bank like Canada, so we can talk to the management and do something.
Yes.
Okay, we'll discuss that part. Thank you.
Sure.
So what are your future goals for VK's creative expression and your work in the social sector field?
We aim for the cancer patients, if we say. Mm-hmm. People in rural areas, mostly women also, they are deprived of not getting
treatment.
Treatment, and they don't go for checkups alone.
Also, it's not happening.
Even forget even rural people. Otherwise, also generally women are only looking out for responsibilities at home. They are not taking care of their own body. So that thing is lacking. So what we feel is we should have one center in the city and in rural area where we have camps and make it mandatory, connecting with women and asking them to come for the camps. And we also planning, like for example, if somebody is a cancer patient, people come from village, get them treated, they get funds from they either mortgage their land and then they come because they want to save their child, right? Once that is done, because they don't have hope, they don't have hope whether she will live long or not, they come with two ideas: either save the child or they think I'll have another child. I don't think she will survive. I will have another child. So this type of thought, no, it should just go out. The reason why they get this thought is they cannot afford to travel, right? The parent is coming again, maybe with father, mother is also coming. They also have to stay somewhere. That is also costing them apart from the hospital expenses. So if not for 100, at least for 10 people space, if we have during the treatment, they stay there with their food, they stay, food is met, and then their treatment is also being done, that would be good. So we are just hoping and planning that we should have such infra where we can provide that service.
All the very best. May God bless you more services for that.
Thank you.
So in this case, when you say, because there is a wide gap which we all can, how does technology play the role in terms of innovation and advancing social development projects?
As I said, we have moving clinics.
Okay, mobile van.
With all the facilities, the bed, with all maybe the X-ray machine, everything. Okay.
How?
If we have those and we capture different districts and conduct programs, it would be really, really good.
Yes, the reach is more in that scenario.
Yeah, because see, people are not all can afford, right, to go for those treatments and checkups. Yeah.
Need not have to wait for a long time for the X-rays to be done and all, to be get diagnosed easily. Yes, that's the best way.
Cost effective as well.
Yes.
Because that's the one thing which everyone looks at. The first thing, go visit a hospital which is far off.
Yes. Yeah, because it is costing them their travel, again their food, right? Their time. When the vehicle is going, maybe it would be a one-time investment for some of the companies who can sponsor. But then we can have doctors. We can hire them for that week. And we can plan for them for different dates.
Yes, yes.
That would be good.
Because camp is just not one time. It'll again.
I would never appreciate any donor also coming to us and saying, "Aap ek camp karoge kya?" I do not want to hear ache at all, because then it pinches, right? People look forward when you walk on the street. They ask, "When are you doing next?"
Yes.
So it is so embarrassing. You have no answer.
Very true. So coming to your past experience in this social sector. So when we say We Heal the Earth program, So we have we are interested in having you as a mentor, coach for an upcoming social franchising initiative. So in these many roles, how do you see yourself in guiding new social entrepreneurs through the Academy of Social Franchising?
I'd be happy at least if somebody can take it ahead.
So in which role would you be interested to go for, as a mentor or a coach or an upcoming social franchisee?
Yes, I would be happy to do.
Great, good to know that. So in terms of collaboration on specific community mobilization and livelihood projects that align with both of our missions,
yes.
Are there any particular areas or projects where you see a strong synergy between our organizations?
Yes, I think your organization is mostly focusing with farmers, right, and environment.
Yes.
With that, we can definitely work. In Maharashtra, we had cleaned one of the dump areas.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And we had also organized some awareness camps where people started growing plants even in their flats. In the societies, because like in South, you have individual houses, right? There, in city like Mumbai, having an individual house is a big deal. So everybody stays in flats there. So having a plant at home is also a boom. So we had created awareness, and I think with your organization, we can definitely do lot and in this activities as well.
Definitely looking forward for collaboration.
Yeah, and then we have artisans working in jute sector, so we can come up with bags wherein instead of pots, you have bags also,
right,
wherein we can cultivate things. We have bags for different causes also.
Wonderful.
And then we are working on terracotta. So with terracotta, we have water bottles. So gifting water bottles or coffee mugs of terracotta is also good. Wow. Children can start utilizing. And then they know terracotta means if it's rough and if it's just throwing the bottle, because it's a plastic bottle, they throw it. Mom, school is over, they throw it. When they're using terracotta, they know if he throws, he has it from his mom. Right? He has to be
careful to use it.
Yeah. So he's also careful and he also knows why he's using that.
And also the value of it.
Yes.
Very interesting to know about your work that you have been impacting so many lives.
There are a lot of collaborations we can do.
After
listening the call.
Yes.
And thank you so much being open for team to scale. We need to come together. That's one thing I can say. But what stage and what stage we can come together and what is the kind of a pricing will match for each other. That we have to discuss. So thank you so much. Being very short, the Sagar will update the editing of video and communication happens. And we'll start quickly as possible.
Thank you all
for your valuable time.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Good day.
And have you here with us.
Thank you.
Have a wonderful